Okay, today's project is to remove the old heater. And we're going to install a new direct vent heater. The heater we're installing is an Ashley 17,000 BTU, model number DVAG17L, and it's for liquid propane. Here's the back side of the heater. Now the exhaust fumes will come out through here. Oxygen or air from the outside of the house will go in here, so it's a complete closed loop system, where the other one basically uses room air and exhaust the flame into the room. And we never felt safe with that, so we're changing out. It's a good looking heater. A little too large, approximately 27 inches, probably 20 inches. A little larger than the one we're pulling out, but it should work fine. Now, the big issue I have today is I've got to cut a hole 11 inches approximately through the house, square hole, and that is going to end up somewhere in this area. Now I have some things to contend with. I have some wire here. This is the phone, which you'll see the outlet on the inside. It's not a big issue if I need to lose it. I don't believe I need to. So I think that vent is going to fall somewhere like right here. So now we need to go in the house and start some dimensions. Find out exactly where she's going to hit. This is where the LP goes in. This is the second regulator. LP connects over there. So, need to pop a few small holes and do some probing, find out where the stud is. And based on stuff I'm seeing here, this house is an original real board and batten. So there are studs running vertically. I believe they are 16 on center based on other projects. But it has nailers. Now, see right here? Here. It goes all the way across. So there are boards that run horizontally. And of course, the studs go vertically. One good thing, I don't see any of those nailer boards here. So that's a good thing. So hopefully I can poke through here, be on the right side of the stud, and everything will come together. Okay, we're gonna start popping some holes. Now we've done this room over. One advantage I have today is I don't need to find a stud to hang the heater on, because this room had 3/4 inch thick knotty pine, tongue and groove, and I never removed it. I left it there and just put the new sheetrock on top. So basically I have mounting spots all over. The key for me is finding the proper place to pop the hole through. So let's bring up the mounting plate and we'll poke a small hole based on an electrical outlet that is behind there and the box. I think a stud is running right about there. So our hole will probably be somewhere in this area. So let's get it laid out and take some dimensions, do some probing and see what we find out. Over a little bit.
a max right there. Probably should check straight up too. They do put nail up blocks in. Go to the south. Okay.
Do is we'll drill some corner pilot holes and then go on the outside and transfer those over. I'm going to put a level on those lines though to make sure they're square, because this one looks like it ran with the bent metal. That one doesn't look too bad, but okay, as you can see, we have the hole through. Now we need to mount this to the wall. screw, small flat washer. Try it with the supplied screws. Those become a problem where you will convert. Stone. Stone.
Safety glasses. Probably the last cut with this wheel. Almost bit me. This is more of a dry fit. Make sure everything works.
Beautiful. Nice and flush. Beautiful. Nice and flush. Now, take the silicone seal, put it on there, up here, and tighten that screw down. There we go. And everything should come in happy at that point. There's plenty of extra room in there, so everything should pull together. Yeah, I like it. All right, let's put that insulation on the big pipe. Looks like we have to trim this down a little bit. That's all right. Real wide broad tape, similar to what I use when I put my wood stove insert in. I'm gonna just butt these. I don't believe they need to be tight. Try to push it in there as is, but I don't think it's going to work. I think I'm going to have to trim her down, but let's give it a shot.
Pushed in there, set on the outside. Both ways for that. Well, here, anyway. Let's see what the instructions show. Let's take a look at that. I have a feeling I got a trim.
Okay, so that's what it looks like installed with the insulation in the trim board. Not bad. Done. A little silicone on it. We'll be painting all this gray, like the house, leave this black. Install was easy. Took a little patience, that's all. All the drip pipe and everything else required is underneath here. I had built this to hide some of those gas fittings because this area is where the main comes in and travels to the rest of the house. So just kind of cleans it up a little bit. See the pilot down there? I just had it on high for about 10-15 minutes.